KWHKG is asking, this is very good. What's your reaction? Now U.S. Embassy convoys will follow the no wang wang, no counterflow directive.
We always follow the law. And I heard yesterday when the president said, walang counterflow. I did hear that. We follow the law wherever we are.
But do you use wang wang? What is wang wang ba?
Siren.
Do you use that?
I've never personally pushed it, but maybe I should start.
But your car doesn't have one.
Our convoy, sure, our convoy uses it.
Your convoy uses
sure,
it.
Yes,
yeah, okay.
Yes.
But I guess you're exempt from that, no? I don't know. All right, Anthony, but will you support it? Will you want your convoy to remove
it? We always follow the law. Okay. Whatever the law is, we follow.
Okay, Anthony Andres is asking, in a scale of 1 to 10, how relevant and important is the Philippines to the United States?
11.
It's only till 10. Can you seriously give a number? Go. So,
okay, Karen, 10. It's extremely important. Okay. We have a long history here. In all seriousness, the United States was here since 1898. There was the Philippine-American War. There was the American occupation. Mm-hmm. And then there was a partnership during World War II to bring democracy here. Mm-hmm. We'll continue to partner with the Philippines and because we're both democracies. We're treaty allies.
No, but I'm curious. Wasn't the Philippines more important then when the U.S. military bases were here? I mean, frankly.
Mm-hmm. No, I can't evaluate that because I wasn't even in the Foreign Service in those days. All I can talk about is what is key now. And for our president, President Obama, he says, what does he always say? Si se puede. Yes, we can. And that means we can partner with all people, including Filipinos, mm-hmm. on issues mm-hmm. that are important, whether they're mm-hmm. military, Peace Corps, USAID, mm-hmm. Education opportunities. Those are things that we will continue to do, but mm-hmm. we can never forget. Yesterday, we took Ambassador Kirk to the cemetery, the American cemetery, to see those 17,000 graves, so we don't forget World War II and the contribution of both of our nations to that effort.
Mm-mm.
Very
but,
important.
No, but seriously, in the Obama administration, mm. where do you see the Philippines? What role do you see us filling in mm. terms really of trade, economic policy? I mean, you know, you have a country like China that's really huge, over a billion people, or India, where they really matter. Mm-hmm. They matter in the economic global scale. Mm-hmm. And when you give out terms like the importance of a relationship, mm-hmm. allies, what is that exactly? We're a very small country.
Look at it this way. You have 90 million people, maybe 90, headed to over 100 million fairly soon. But you're a democracy. You have a representative democracy. America is the largest investor here. Okay. We're one of the largest aid donors. That will continue. Mm-hmm. You are our 15th largest market for American agricultural products. Mm-hmm. Two-way trade is increasing despite the global recession. I have had the opportunity to visit Lexmark in Cebu and see the wonderful work they're doing in exporting. I want to visit Timex and see what they're doing. Mm-hmm. But you know, what most struck me is that Pepsi Cola is going to make their plant here 100% renewable energy. Mm. That's the future. Wind power, solar power, and American corporations want to partner with the Philippines on that.
All right. Okay. Now, moving on slightly off track.
Karen.
I'm curious, how do you rate President Arroyo's leadership in the last 9 years?
I think that's not for me. I think that's for the Filipino people. But we want to clearly say that it was important that there was a peaceful transfer of power, and she did what she said she would do.
Why would it have been important for the United States that there was a peaceful transition of power instead of the Philippines moving on to charter change or to a parliamentary system? I'm saying, why is that important to America?
Well, clearly, we always like to see a peaceful transfer of power. That's what democracies do. If the Philippines, however, decides on a charter change, that's up to the Philippines government and its people. We don't criticize that. Obviously, we are very close friends with governments that have parliamentary democracies, India, Britain, Canada. So that's not something we oppose. We have no opinion on it. It's up to a democracy to decide what type of government they would like.
Mm-mm. I'm just curious, were you happy with Smartmatic?
Smartmatic.
Because in the United States, they have a few cases.
You know, all we, when we look at elections, we're humble. We've had challenges with our own elections. So we look from afar. We sent over 120 election observers out. We saw that the will of the people was reflected. But it's not for us to comment on individual companies or systems.
Mm-mm. All right, more questions here. This is cute. You say you don't dance, but do you sing?
No. My wife is a jazz musician.
But can you sing?
I was one of two people in the elementary school not allowed to sing.
Liar.
You know,
come
it's true.
Come on, really?
Sterling Carey and me were banished to the back of this.
You can't carry a tune. I can't to save my life. I can't do it.
I'm telling you.
Really?
It's traumatic. Banished to the back of the auditorium and told to sit down and not sing. So that was tough.
But you can't sing a bit.
I cannot sing at all.
I was going to ask you to sing a bit.
Oh, you don't want to hear me sing.
I do.
Everybody will be crying.
I'm curious. No. Rebecca, say no.
No. I can't sing.
All right. Do you follow any sports team?
Oh, you know, in America, I'm a New York Mets and a New York Giants fan. I've been to a couple of PBA games here. I've seen Talk and Text and San Miguel.
But you're not a basketball fan. You're more of a baseball fan.
Well, I love baseball, but I'm from New York City. That's the mecca of basketball. Of course I love basketball. And I went to a Jesuit school. So I'm looking forward to seeing the Ateneo and LaSalle games. I can't wait.
All right. Name me an actress you find beautiful.
Karen DeVille?
No, I'm not an actress. Good diplomatic, guys. No, I'm kidding. No, if any Filipino actress.
Filipino?
Have you seen anyone?
I haven't, but you know who I really like? Charmaine Clamore, who is a great jazz singer in America. Uh-huh. She was born in Subic, and she's now the number 4 rated jazz singer in America. She comes to the Philippines once a year, and I can't wait until she comes again.
Really?
She has a great song out.
Is she half Filipino?
She is full, 100% Filipino.
Okay.
And she has 8 CDs, one American jazz standards, one is Filipino mm-hmm. folk songs, but one is called My Funny Valentine, which is a great song, but she calls it My Funny Brown Valentine, where she says, my skin is brown, my nose is flat, but I am beautiful. It's a tribute to Filipino women
telling them to
love, embrace themselves.
I like that.
It's a great song.
But have you heard India Ari?
Of course I've heard India Ari.
Love India Ari.
Of course I love India Ari.
No, there's another. I think she's better than Tracy Chapman. India Ari is very good. Okay. Are you active on Facebook?
I am.
Oh, you are?
Sure.
Okay.
Who isn't?
Me? I'm not. I mean, Facebook's so hard. Now, what's your name on Facebook?
Harry K. Thomas.
Harry K. Thomas.
Sure.
What about Twitter?
No, I haven't used Twitter yet.
You have not yet?
No.
Well, I mean, will people be able to reach you? Will you converse with them? I think that's what people are curious about.
No, you know, I only converse with friends. I know that Ambassador Kenny used Facebook herself. But what we use it for is to explain to the Filipino people what the American government and our embassy is doing here. We've had people, Americans and Filipinos, talk about their jobs. We had our student interns this week talk about what they're doing this summer, Mm-mm. our cemetery, all of these things.
Mm-mm. All right, last question. Just one last. They're telling me to wrap up. Now, this is interesting. What is the significance, Sikotik is asking, of an African-American ambassador appointed to the Philippines?
Well, primarily, first of all, I am an American ambassador. And when in our embassy, we don't do that. We don't say Filipino-American, European-American, Asian-American. We just say Americans. And that's the great thing about our nation.
All right. Okay. Well, I won't ask any more nursing questions because it's way too complicated for you. But, sir, welcome to the Philippines.
Maraming salamat. Saludo ako sa inyong lahat.
Ah, very good. Yeah. Okay. And I wish you well. And I hope you do your job well as well.
Thank you. Very
All
kind.
Right.
See you next time.
Thank you, Ambassador Thomas. We'll be bringing you scenes now from last night's inaugural street party at the Quezon Memorial after the break. So stay tuned.